I would lie in my bed and hear the voices of my parents fighting underneath me night after night, all of their words like a claw in my chest. I would go for days without talking, days and nights and days. There was only one place I found peace, and that was under my dear grandmother's skirts, a kind of chapel there. Blossom was her name. Her real name was Catherine, but they called her Blossom. It was dark and fragrant under there. For 7-Eleven, I think. Lemonish scent. And I loved to look at her veiny legs. Beautiful blue works. Tea and toast. Sweet wine. Falling asleep together. She lived with us. She spent her time looking out the window and painting flower colors of birds. And my mother was always exasperated with her. Mother, get out of the kitchen! Mother, do you need to go to the toilet? When she fell and broke her hip, she was moved to a home for the aged. It smelled of physohex and creamed corn. The look on her face, when she left her there, on that cold autumn morning, sitting on her designated bed, she held onto her coat and the look of, there is no word. And I stood there, treachery, looking at the floor. A few weeks later, my grandmother walked out of the home with a razor blade she had stolen from one of the old men, and into the Rosehill Ravine, and she cut her wrists, and she walked and walked through the brown and yellow leaves, and she turned in circles and bowed deeply, I think.
Dear friend, I am so sorry. My life. There are times when I catch in the sun.